Jesus said, you worship you know not what. We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. My assignment today is to help those that worshiping wrong. Yes, you are worshiping wrong. There are people that's in the church, my friend. Hey, glory to God. There, even if you are at home, you are worshiping wrong. If you, glory to God, spend more time with things, it become your God. So the woman at the well say, Jerusalem is the place where men ought to worship. But Jesus Christ told her, woman, the hour cometh, and now is, where the true worshiper shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeks such to worship, and God is a spirit. And they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. So my assignment is, who are you worshiping? Yes, who are you worshiping? Because when it comes to worship, worship means to adore. Worship means to celebrate. Worship means to give obedience to something that you adore. So if your car become your adoring, you spend more time with your car than you spend time with the God that make the car. So glory to God, people that wash their car day after day and never want to wash their heart. You spend more time with your house. You live in your house. You rather stay in your house when church time come, but never tend the house of God. So the house become your God. When you come, even go to church, you fold your hands and you act like Alice in Wonderland. So glory to God, you become a prospector, you become a critic, you become a fan and not a follower. So a fan, they will sit there, they will stand there, and they'll fold their hand and they'll be like Alice in Wonderland. So Jesus Christ say, glory to God, the hour cometh, and now is when the true worshipers, we want to go to heaven, but we don't want to worship God. I don't understand that analogy. We are the poor Christian, ought to be the happiest people in the world. We are the, supposed to be the worshipers. We just worship God. Look, example, I'll give a prime example. People that love the Washington Redskins. People love the Dallas Cowboys. People love, glory to God, the Patriots. People love the Philadelphia Eagles. When those people comes on, when you score a touchdown, they get excited. They are a jubilant, my friend. When Michael Jackson, when Prince, when all the greatest artists sing, they scream, they faint. But when it comes to God, the creator of the universe, we don't get excited. That's why I'm excited. People ask, how am I doing? I say, I'm fantastic. I'm fabulous. Glory to God. You know why? Because this is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I'm glad that I'm saved. I'm glad that I'm born again. I'm glad that I know who Jesus is. I'm jubilant, not because somebody scored a touchdown. Every day of my life, God scored a touchdown in my life. I'm awoke, hallelujah, got my right mind. I got eyes to see, I got mouth to speak, ears to hear, nose to smell, hands to feel, and a feet to walk. My friend, glory to God. And if those people in a wheelchair are happy, glory to God, hallelujah, and we got the activity of our limbs, and we're not worshiping Him, hey, glory to God. So when Jesus told a woman, woman, the hour cometh and now is, where the true worshiper shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. And my question is, my friend, are you worshiping God in spirit? Glory to God. Are you worshiping God in spirit and in truth? What is truth? I'm so glad you asked. The Bible say, my friend, glory to God, hallelujah, and ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. A lot of you all that watch me right now, happy people are free people. Hey, glory to God. Who the Son set free, they are free indeed. So if you are happy, I made a video, if you are happy and you know it, say amen. I can say amen because I'm happy and I'm free. A free people, even though they have money in the bank, money in their pocket, hallelujah, they don't know where their next meal comes from. They know that God will provide. David said, hallelujah, I've been young, but now I'm old, never seen the righteous forsaken, nor a seed begging bread. So I'm happy, and I'm worshiping God because I know the truth, and I have the spirit. So the Bible says, glory to God, God is a spirit, and they that worship, hallelujah, it's time for us as being people, being Christian, glory to God, worship God. God is not a object. God is not your car. God is not your house. God is not your job. God is not your children. God is not your spouse. But God is not, my friend, God is not the idol we sit in our living room and worship him. That's why I used to be a Catholic. Glory to God, was next to be a priest. But I'm so glad that God peeped into my future and God said, no, I want you to be a Christian. I want you to worship the living and the true God. And I can tell you, my friend, I am happy not because I'm a millionaire, even though I am a millionaire, because I know him, that he said, I supply all your needs according to his riches in glory. A cattle upon a thousand hill belong to him. If he was hungry, he wouldn't tell thee. So I am rich. Hey, I'm wealthy because I know the creator of the universe. Hey, glory to God. That's why, my friend, I am a true worshiper. Are you, be honest, are you a true worshiper? If you have the Holy Ghost, not Casper the Friendly Ghost, glory to God, not a thrill, but being filled. If you have the Holy Ghost, we are supposed to be the worshiper. The true worshipers take the stand and tell what God have done for you. God have woke me up this morning. God has stopped me on my way. God gave me activity off my limb. God have given me the chance for a second chance. Yes, a second chance in life. When I look back on my life, Paul said, glory to God, hallelujah. Glory to God, when I look back and see what the Lord have done, my friend, he said, forgetting those things which are behind. I'm so glad that I don't live my past. I live my present, and I'm living toward my future. That's why worshipers worship God. We are warring. Hallelujah. We are warring because the devil's on our trail, and we are worshiping God to get the devil out of our trail. The Bible says, the God of peace have bruised Satan under our feet. Each time we worshiping God, each time we praising God, my friend, we are bruising Satan under our feet. Mother, glory to God, if you are going through circumstances in your life, I introduce you to praise, because God lives in praise. God lives in worship. God lives when we lift our hands and say glory to God. When we don't, my friend, the Bible says, weeping men do it for a night, but joy cometh. Hey, hop on shot. Cometh in the morning. The Bible says, weeping. When you weep, I thank God for midnight. Because when Paul and Silas, glory to God, when they was in the jail cell, hey, and Paul was praising, and Silas was praying, and at midnight, glory to God, I thank God for midnight. I thank God that God turned hopeless situation around. So true worshipers, are you a true worshiper? My friend, if you are a true worshiper, you can identify and say amen. Glory to God. Because I come by to stop by to tell somebody out there, you are going through. And the best thing to do, my friend, is not to complain. But David said, I will bless the Lord at all time, not just on payday, not on promotion, not on presence, but glory to God when God been good to me. Has God been good to you? If God been good to you, you ought to say glory, hallelujah, 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 because I'm preparing, glory to God, for heaven. When in heaven, my friend, if you don't praise God down here, don't expect to go up there, because praising God and worshiping God gonna be in his presence. In the presence of the Lord, there's fullness of joy. At thy right hand, there are pleasure forevermore. So true worshipers, we are preparing for heaven. I know a lot of people, my friend, don't understand life journey church, but life journey church is preparing people to get to heaven. On my other channel, my friend, it called New Glory to God Heaven and New Jerusalem Journey. That site would tell you about heaven. So life journey is preparing you for heaven. I'm preparing people that subscribe to my video. I'm preparing you for heaven. I'm not preparing you for hell. I'm preparing you to see when God gonna say, well done, my good and faithful servant, you've been faithful of a few things. Enter into the joy of the Lord. I'm preparing you to see your Jesus, because my friend, God is looking for true worshipers. If you are a true worshiper, you know what I'm saying. Because true worshipers, my friend, God will say, I'm going to wipe all tears from your eye. True worshipers, my friend, they glory to God. They're going to be in the midst of God. And God said, I'm going to give you all things new. All things going to be new. Glory to God. They're going to be no more tears, no more weeping, no more night, no more day. All things are become new. So I'm waiting for that day. So while I'm waiting for that day, I'm becoming a true worshiper now. I am warring and worshiping the living and true God. God is coming back, my friend. And if we are complaining, we're going to miss it. If we are glory to God, we're not preparing ourselves to praise God down here. We get excited for our sports, our familia. We get excited for our artists in a coliseum or a theater. But I'm excited about Jesus. I'm excited about the Holy Ghost. I'm excited about being saved, being sanctified, being Holy Ghost filled. How many people, my friend, are born again? How many people have experienced a new birth, the new deliverance, the new glory? I'm excited, my friend. Glory to God. Are you excited about being born again? How many people out there are born again? Glory to God. If you are born again, you can identify to be a true worshiper. So Jesus Christ told the woman at the well, the hour cometh and now is when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. Do you have the spirit or do you have the truth? Because the Bible says, Jesus Christ said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man come to the Father but by me. If you are not of the truth, the Bible said, there's a way that seems right unto a man, but the end thereof is the way of death. So your way might not be God's way. There's only one way. Oprah, T.D. Jakes, and all those guys say there are many ways, but the Bible say, I am one. There's one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. That's why, my friend, there's only one God. There's only one God, one mediator between God and man, the Christ Jesus. The Bible say, every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. So if we are not worshiping the real and the true living God, we can't worship the right way. So Jesus Christ said to the woman, woman, the hour cometh and now is where the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship him. God is a spirit. God is not a thing. God is not your house. God is not your car. God is not your clothes, God is not your spouse, God is not your children, but God is a spirit. God is an invisible being, and some of us are worshiping the wrong way. If you don't have the Spirit of God, you can't worship the right way, because God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Glory to God.